right. Okay, Jimmy, as you know, we like to see if things will. And the thing we're going to find out if it will tonight is tea.
So we have steeped a bunch of different things in some hot water to find out. Will it tea?
All right, here we go. Guys, what is up first?
All right, first up, we thought we'd spice things up by going south of the border with a little taco seasoning.
Taco seasoning. Will it tea?
You almost said that with an Irish accent. That's
very interesting. I was like, what should I go with?
A little taco seasoning. That's south of the border.
Right. The Irish border.
The Irish border. Yeah. It's got to be a border.
I'm glad you're feeling me.
I mean, this is taco seasoning, as you can see.
Yeah.
And as you can see, as it has discolored the water significantly. It seems like this makes a good potential tea.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, yeah, I mean, it's definitely seeping through. It's got that, it's got the scent of a...
Of a taco.
Of a taco. That is true.
Yeah, okay.
All right, shall we...
We like to dink it and sink it.
Dink it.
Dink it.
And?
Drink it or sink it?
Drink it.
Drink it if you want. I'm gonna sink it.
Sorry. No. Well,
you guys look like you don't feel it, but I'm feeling it.
Well, maybe because you sunk it and we drank. Wait, really? You're feeling this?
It's like when you strain the taco meat and you don't eat the meat.
When does that happen again?
It happens all the time at my house.
You strain.
Am I the only one that eats the strainings?
I don't know, man.
We don't have to all agree. I mean, will it tea?
No.
Yes.
No.
Okay, that's fine. My feelings are not hurt, dude. Okay, for this next one, who doesn't love a good scented tea?
That's a good question.
And what's the best way to make something smell good other than deodorant?
Deodorant. Will it tea?
Okay. What should we call this tea?
Teodorant.
Yeah. Of course, teodorant.
Yeah.
All right, this is getting...
Okay, before you get into this one, I want to let you know.
Okay.
Now, we have our own custom barf buckets that we take around with us everywhere we go.
That's your custom barf buckets.
And, of course, 'tis the season to give.
My man.
Jimmy.
You might need one.
We've made your own... That's you.
That's definitely me.
That's you and... That's your barf.
That's my barf, if I have ever seen it before. That is it.
Keep that handy.
Thank you, my friend. I appreciate this. That is very nice of you guys.
Now, this is totally safe. This is all natural. Okay?
Okay. I can already smell. This smells soapy. It
smells soap.
This smells almost like a bug repellent or something.
Yeah, it's a little strong.
It's a strong.
A little strong.
It's a strong tea.
In a good
Some people
way.
Like it that yep. way.
Okay, good.
All right, dink it.
Dink it. And sink it.
Sink it.
I didn't spit that out, but I was really close to it. That is terrible. It coats the inside of your mouth. It feels like, oh, that is rough. That is bad news, Bears. Oh. That is bad news.
There's nothing good about that.
Hold on, the breath may be good.
Okay.
Oh. I love how you had to breathe in my face. I was like, no, I'm breathing in your face.
I know, for a second, I was like, oh. I didn't know if I was getting
breathed in. There's got to be a smeller. There's got to be a smeller.
You're the smeller.
I was the smeller,
right, double smell.
Oh, it's not
bad.
That is really nice.
It's not bad. There might be something to
really
that.
That's really nice.
Someone who has halitosis, but if that's not the option, I'm going to say that this will not tea.
Will it tea?
No.
What is our next
okay,
tea?
Okay, no tea tasting would be complete without some goat meat.
Goat meat. Will it tea?
Okay.
Okay. So we wanted to see if goat would tea just so we could call it goatee.
Oh, goatee, of course.
Goatee.
Oh, you gotta sometimes just gotta go for it.
And you can't drink goatee without goatees. So this is probably gonna work a little bit better for you guys. But I do believe in redundancy in facial hair.
Hey, not bad. Hey, you can start the two-tone goatee. I think it looks kind of cool.
Oh, look.
Hey, not bad.
I can't tell anything's happening.
It blends right in until it falls.
Yeah. We look like three cool dudes, man.
Yeah.
Oh, would you like a little goat in your tea?
How would you like a little goat in your tea? I'm sure they probably do in Ireland. All right, wait. Oh, this is rough already. It smells like jerky to me.
It doesn't smell good.
It smells like a stew.
Oh, that's true. It does. Mm. Yeah, not as bad as you'd think. All right. Are we...
Dink it.
Dink it.
I'm just going to let my beard fall off.
That's all right.
It knocked your face off. It's not good.
You better drink this, it'll knock your face off. I don't mind it.
That is pretty good, is it not?
It's like a broth, man.
Yeah, it's
like I think we've invented broth.
We invented broth.
Went around the back end and ended up at broth again.
I don't mind it.
Yeah, yeah. This could work.
Yeah. Go tea. Yeah.
Will it tea?
Yeah.
Yes!
That's good. Not bad. Go to it. Right. I'm going to leave this home.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'll leave
you leave that home. That's good. Yeah, perfect.
This last one scares me, especially for you, Jimmy, because we do this kind of thing all the time. We do stupid stuff all the time. We ingest things that we shouldn't.
Oh, not me.
But you don't do it all the time.
No.
So this one is an especially hot tea, and by hot, I don't mean temperature. I mean we made it out of ghost peppers.
Ghost pepper. Will it tea?
All right, this is ghost peppers, and this is for real. This is really ghost pepper in here.
Yeah. Really?
I can kind of...
Oh, you can smell it. Oh!
Oh, this is...
It's like a smoky chipotle.
Whoa.
Chipotle type of pepper in there. Yeah, I mean, this...
It got me. Just smelling it has cleared the sinuses.
Yeah, this one's gotta go down.
Okay, yeah.
This one flipped my stash out.
Yeah.
This is a ghost pepper. Mm-hmm. All right, this one I gotta get.
Yeah, get ready. Get ready. Yeah. You definitely should get ready on this one.
Yeah, okay, because we're
gonna... there's no shame in the vomit game.
Thank you.
Sulp it. And gulp it. I don't know what salt is.
Salt and gulp it doesn't matter. Here we go.
I don't know.
Ghost pepper tea.
Do we have other tea that's not hot tea?
We do not have anything but hot tea. It's way too hot. It's actually hot. Do you have any water or anything? Sure. I don't want milk.
Water makes it worse.
Oh, I don't want milk at all. Do you want milk?
Look, we got a whole pyramid of peanut butter crackers.
I don't know what that is. Yeah, I want to drink milk. Okay, I'll just let it burn. I'm going to say, you can ask the question.
How about I let you wait a little bit?
I know, you're right. Let's do a peanut butter cracker right quick.
Will it tea?
That's tough.
I don't know.
I don't know. No, it's hot. It hurts.
I mean, it is tea.
Well,
but it's not tea that I want to drink.
But that doesn't mean that it won't tea. Some people might choose to enjoy
it. Yeah, because it is tea. I don't know. We gotta be the jury on this one. Will it tea?
No.
Yes. No. Yeah,
no.
Good mythical morning.
Now, as you know, on our show, we like to see if things will. And the thing we are going to find out if it will tonight is s'mores.
Will it s'more?
Very nice. Okay. Guys, what is up first?
All right, for this first s'more, we thought we'd start with an Italian classic, a pizza.
Pizza. Will it s'more?
Oh, my gosh. What a fantastic accent. Wow. Have you spent time in Italy?
No.
Yeah.
All right. Let's sit right here and let's take a peek at this guy. All right, first, let's put on our goggles.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's talk about this.
Here. Why exactly did we put on goggles?
I don't know. Is there any reason?
Not
there's
I
no
know.
Reason.
Well, let's we don't cool. need, we let's, don't... Let's be cool about it, though, when we take them off.
Sure.
Let's be cool about it.
Now.
Okay, as you can see, we have replaced the graham crackers with cafeteria square pizza.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
What do you think we should call this one?
How about, that's a s'more.
that's it. That's exactly it. And this is like a dipping sauce next to it?
Well, they call that marinara in Italy.
You haven't been either, have you?
No, I've been on the internet, though.
I gotta try that. All right, here we go.
Let's dip it.
We're gonna try this.
We gotta dip it, and then we gotta dink
it. Let's dink it.
Dink it. And sink it.
And sink it.
What just happened?
Somebody shot something at me. A spitball or a ping pong ball.
It's gonna be a long night for you.
I know, I could not handle that. I can't handle that, man.
Really?
No.
I thought there was something special about this.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, it's like, you had more you had to get rid of?
I had some other piece. It was marshmallowed in there. I didn't know. I did not enjoy that at all.
If you're not, you've gotta be committed to the science.
Okay, well, I am.
If we have to answer the question, and you gotta, I mean, if it doesn't go all the way down, there's only so much you can know.
We have to digest this more before we can talk about it?
Well, there are more rounds, so, okay, we'll give you a pass on this one.
As long as one of us eats it and goes...
I experienced pizza and dessert pizza at the same time.
Mm, yeah.
Okay, I think, what do you think?
Well, will it s'more?
Yeah.
Okay, have you ever made yourself a s'more and thought, I wish this tasted more like the ocean?
No.
Well, whether you have or not, it doesn't matter because that's what's about to happen.
Oh, no.
Fish. Will it s'more?
I'm gonna get up.
Okay, so as you can see, we have replaced the marshmallow with fish. We do this so they don't have to.
Yeah,
I know, yeah.
They won't know if this will s'more if we don't try it.
All right. I think it's pretty clear this is not going to s'more.
You don't know.
It's like sardines or something?
Yeah.
All right, what do we call this s'more?
Finding s'morey.
Okay, good.
No. I like to call this one, She Sells by the Sea S'more.
All right, there you go, here we go.
Tough to say.
All right, let's try it, here we go.
Now, you might want to donkey lift this one first. Sometimes that helps us.
I have no idea what that means.
Okay, it's an eating technique that we've come up with, just like a donkey does. You ever watch a donkey eat?
Sure.
They lip things before they begin eating it. So just lip it a little bit.
Stop doing that.
It's just getting your mouth ready for what's about to happen. Just lip.
Yeah. I don't know if I can doggy lip it.
Okay.
Come on.
Oh, you got it down.
Yeah.
Oh.
It counts.
It was horrible.
That was.
Now we know.
I think we knew going in. All right.
Does it s'more?
No, that will not s'more. That was disgusting. That tasted like a mistake. Gosh. Total mistake. No, all right, sorry.
All right, for this next one, we're gonna get even more experimental, and we have decided to replace the classic marshmallow. Well, we're not gonna replace it. We're just gonna give it a little bit of a tan.
Okay.
With some tanning spray. Tanning spray.
Will it s'more?
Okay. Now, right now, this is just a regular s'more, but we're about to change the world of this s'more.
Yeah, sorry, before we go further. So why are we doing this? I mean, why are we? This looks tan enough. This is looks like
it's
it was
a little uneven, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
Let's even that tan up.
So an uneven tan?
Just
this is tanning spray.
Now this is totally safe. You typically shouldn't eat tanning spray, but this is all natural. I mean, still don't try this at home. That's why we're doing it.
Oh my God. All right.
Oh, thanks.
No problem. I just want to make sure you got all of it.
Okay.
All right. That's more than enough. What? All right, so you can eat this, but kids, do not eat this. Right. Do not try this at home.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't eat canned tanning spray.
This is a safe version that we've found somehow.
All right.
Yeah. We call this one Jersey S'more.
Yeah, I got that. All right, let's taste this guy.
Dink it.
Dink it and sink it.
It's a little
like bug spray, but
it's like a trip to the islands.
It's like a beach inside.
It's like fun in your belly.
Will it s'more?
Yes!
This is
all right, we got one more. This last one scares me a little bit, but I think it's gonna scare Rhett a lot because it is his food nemesis. Liver.
Liver. Will it s'more?
Yeah. Oh gosh.
All right, what if have you ever blindfolded yourself? Liver, what are we calling this one?
How about internal smorgon?
Oh, man.
Now, listen, you're still gonna know what it is. I mean, it's still liver.
What's that?
It's still liver.
I was just zoning out, though.
Okay. Yeah, open wide.
Good gosh.
All right, dink it.
Oh, no. I'm just gonna get it ready. This is insane.
Here we go. I gave it my all.
I know. I tried to.
The aftertaste.
I want more of that tanning liquid. You got any of that tanning liquid?
Yeah, it's gone.
That was good.
All okay, right. Will it s'more? No.
No, absolutely not. All right, there he goes. There you have it right there. Just for the record, the only thing that s'mored was the tanning lotion.
Jimmy, as you know, when you have us on your show, we like to get you to eat questionable things in the name of science.
So tonight it's time to ask the age-old question, will it hot dog?
Let's talk about that. Good mythical morning.
Now on our show, we like to see if things will, and since it's grilling season, the thing we're gonna find out if it will tonight is hot dogs.
Will it hot dog?
All right, here we go. What is up first? What will we see if it will tonight?
Well, have you ever been out at sea and thought to yourself, man, I could really use a hot dog?
Yes.
So many times, you have no idea.
Yeah. Today is your lucky day.
Yeah.
Sushi. Will it hot dog?
Okay.
Okay. As you can see, there is no wiener. We have replaced the wiener with sushi.
I got you.
We've really classed up the hot dog already.
Yeah, okay, good. It looks beautiful. Let me see.
It does look pretty great. Classy.
Yeah, it's very classy. Absolutely. Okay.
We call this raw dog. I just invented the term.
That is good. Yeah.
Never applied to anything else.
Even had a little accent on it, too.
Raw dog.
Raw dog.
Now, yeah. I typically do not put ketchup on my sushi, but I also typically do not put sushi on my hot dog, so.
Oh my God! Oh, your mustard.
You want some
good? No, I always put soy sauce on my hot dogs.
Okay.
Always.
All right.
That's always what I put on my hot dogs. There's some soy for my raw dog.
Let's dink it and sink it.
Dink it.
Okay, your mustard got on my hot dog.
That's good.
Here we go. 1, 2.
Oh, you said, look, you already ate it. Mm.
I think the ketchup was a mistake.
I think the sushi was a mistake.
No. You think that. I have my answer.
Okay, so I typically don't like sushi, but I'm not gagging.
Yeah, because okay. If we do gag, we all have...
We're all ready for that.
Our Willett barf buckets. And so none of us barfed on this
one. Willett hot dog?
Yes.
Yeah, I think it will hot dog.
Think so?
It will, right?
Yeah, it did.
Yeah, totally hot dog.
Okay. Typically, I get a little thirsty when I eat a hot dog, and what better way to quench that thirst than with soup?
Soup.
Willett hot dog?
So now what we've done is, I mean, that just looks like a wiener, man.
Yeah.
But it's full of tomato soup.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm just kidding.
No, this is gonna be great.
I'm getting that. I don't even know why you're holding it like that. Well,
I'm just I'm just demonstrating the lack of structural integrity.
Lack of structural integrity. Yeah. Okay.
But that's not what this is about. Man.
No. What do we call this hot dog?
We call this the soup doggy dog.
Soup doggy dog.
The dog.
Soup doggy dog. All right, so soup doggy dog looks good.
You were gonna be like sipping on gin and soup.
No. This is, here we go. Yeah. Do you want to? Let's
think it.
I don't know what's gonna happen when we bite into this.
It might burst.
I'm a texture guy, and that just bummed me out. But I don't want to give away my. I don't want to give away my answer there.
I wonder if it was warm. If it was warm,
yeah,
it'd be different.
If it was warm.
It's a cold soup. This is more of a gazpacho.
So let's just go theoretically. Willett hot dog?
No. That's what I said.
What?
Oh, wait, we asked Willett hot dog.
You said theoretically, yes.
Yes.
What?
Practically?
No.
No.
I'm not confused.
All right, let's move on. What's the only thing better than underwear you can wear? Underwear you can eat. I'm talking about edible underwear.
Edible underwear.
Like, wait, where are you going?
Willett hot dog.
All right, good. Okay, it's pretty straightforward. We've got edible underwear on the hot dog. Now, every other time I've enjoyed these, it was more complicated than this.
Yeah.
I didn't know this is what it looked like.
Everyone does. Do we? Well, mine looks like they've been worn. I know. Right? They kind of do, right?
There's a little, yeah.
We chose those for you.
I appreciate that.
You got to know if they
don't
fit.
Don't tell me which one, yeah. And now is the black part of the...
Yeah, that's chocolate, and then there's strawberry is the floss section.
Really, yeah.
Don't call it the floss section, please, yeah. All right.
You just want to stuff it all, in there in
just
the bun.
Put it all in there. This is edible underwear, and what should we call this dog?
I call it the underdog. I'm really pulling for
this. No, it's good. Yeah.
Okay.
You're really pulling for this, and yeah.
Dink it?
You cracked me up, get it? All right, here we go. Dink it, and here we go.
These things really hold up.
I got a mouthful of bun right there.
I mean, there's a lot more support in this than you realize.
Yeah.
I have my answer for
Common
this.
Common problem.
Yeah.
But Willett hot dog?
I'm gonna say no.
No. I'd say
no.
I was enjoying myself over here.
No, I know.
You do that on your own time.
That's okay. Your thing, yeah.
All right, majority rules, no, it will not.
Edible underwear will not, no, this guy's still totally.
Okay. Yeah. And finally, for this last one, we're gonna make a hot dog for dogs by filling it with dog food.
Dog food. Willett hot dog.
Mm.
What just happened? What just happened? What just happened?
They just looked at it.
What? Oh my gosh!
That's all.
I can't even look at it. I'm smelling it. I'm freaking out right now. I'm smelling it. It smells like dog food. I love my dog. I'm glad my dog eats food, but this is not.
In the name of science and discovery.
Oh, goodness gracious, hold on a second.
But Jimmy, focus. This is important. If this hot dog, it's gonna change people's culinary habits for minutes.
But all right, so let's just think. Again, it's cold, right?
Yeah.
So it could be like a chili dog or something like that, right?
Well, hold on. Before we eat it, I do think we have to christen this thing.
Oh, yeah. What is the name of this one?
How about we call this one Kibbles and I Don't Think I Want to Eat This.
But we have to.
We have to. Take it. I'm so glad you do it. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh.
They said it couldn't be done.
And now we're saying it shouldn't be done.
But the operative question is, will it hot dog? Of course not.
No!
That was one of the most disgusting things.
Ruth won't even look at me.
Quest won't even look at me right now. It's so gross. All right, for just for the record, how many things did hot dog?
Just the first one, right?
Yeah, just the first one, hot dog. This last one was a total, total nightmare.
But now we know.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's all that matters.
Yeah, now you don't have to do this.
See, that's why I love you guys. That's why you guys exist. Good
mythical morning.
Now, on our show, we like to see if things will, and the thing we're gonna find out tonight, if it will, is hummus. Okay.
Hummus.
Will it hummus?
Guys, what is that? What is the first one up here? This is, you know, I love playing these games, but man, oh man,
I have a week. Are you hungry?
Yes.
For science?
Yes, I'm hungry for science.
Yes.
But I'm always questioning these questionable things here. What is the first one up here?
All right. Now, typically, I eat my dessert after my hummus. But what if there was a hummus that allows you to do both in tandem? Three Musketeers.
Will it hummus? Yeah. See this treat before you. We've dissolved some Three Musketeers into chickpeas, lemon, and tahini. It's hummus. It's just hummus.
Mm-hmm. It's just hummus.
It's just hummus.
Yeah. Okay.
And we call this one Three Hummusketeers.
All right. So.
That's how I pronounce the normal candy bar anyway. Three Hummusketeers.
Now they're getting worked up, but
right,
we've got to taste it. You don't know until you dip it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And then we got to. We gotta dink it, so we gotta do a three-way dinking.
Yeah, you gotta dink.
And then sink.
Dink it, dink it, and sink it.
And sink it. You don't like your chickpeas with chocolate?
Is that tahini or something that just, all right.
Yeah, there's a little tahini-ness.
I don't know about this at all, but I.
It has a nice finish. It has a nice finish.
It's like a nice ending to a great walk on the Mediterranean Sea.
A walk on the sea?
Maybe right beside it.
Okay.
Wow.
All right, but will it hummus?
Yes!
No!
Hummus! This is not hummus!
Hey, listen.
Wait, what? Am I too judgmental?
If this doesn't
hummus. Is that hummus?
If this doesn't hummus, you don't know where we're going from here.
All right, I should just be thankful that this hummus for a little bit.
Okay.
All right.
You ever been walking around next to the Mediterranean Sea, if you
will?
Oh,
yeah. Sometimes I've walked on it.
Very hungry, and you thought to yourself, you know what I'd like to eat in hummus form? Ground beef, box pasta, and powdered sauce. Well, now you can. Hamburger helper.
Will it hummus?
All right. I think this is gonna work.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is 75% of my diet from grade school all through college. Right. It's just mashed up like a baby food.
Yeah, okay.
It's a full meal.
That's
it's
true.
It's got that going because Hamburger Helper is already a full meal.
We love Hamburger Helper. He's a, he's a four-fingered walking glove. Yes. And he's just here to help.
What's not to love about the glove?
He's here to help. You got to love the glove and get some hamburger involved. Yeah. Here we go. All right.
We call this one Hamburger Help Us.
All right. Are you getting chunks in yours?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Get some chunks. Oh, it is thick.
Oh, yeah. This is thick. It's real thick.
It's also cold, you know?
Yeah, that's true.
Typically, but that's not how I enjoy my helper.
You're going light, huh?
I went too light. I can't even dink this.
Yeah, I'll just
dink it.
No!
You're
special. You're right. God. All right.
Dude, you give me an extra dink and sink it.
You tell us. What do you love about it?
This is fantastic.
It's great.
I think it's gonna work. This should be a thing.
Yeah. Will it hummus?
Yes! It's will hummus!
Of course, we're not done. Now it is time for the hummus that is best eaten during happy hour.
Rum and Coke.
Will it hummus?
That.
Yes, okay. What we've done here is we've syrupied some Coke, mm-hmm. and we've mixed it in with chickpeas and rum with a splash of lime.
Yeah, I could smell the lime mm-hmm. and the booze.
We're calling this rummus and Coke.
Okay. Oof, oof, oof. Okay, here you go.
Thank you.
No problem. All right, so you're gonna
give it a nice circular.
Man, you got a really good. You guys could do dinks. I'm like, this is like. Oh, yeah, an extra little lime squeeze on there.
Yeah.
All right, rummus and Coke.
Oh, that's good. That's nice.
All right, here we go.
Dink it
and sink it.
Whoa. Heavy on the rummus.
Habana, unana. Wow.
Woo.
Wait, was that syrup or was that rum, I think?
That was both.
Oh, man.
Holy moly. A lot of rum. You know, it came on pretty strong.
It came on real strong. And I feel like if I had that and got pulled over, I'd be in jail right now.
It's just hummus, sir.
Your officer is just hummus. It wouldn't be, believe me.
So, will it hummus?
No. It tasted like poison. That was not hummus.
That was poisonous.
Well, boys, it's good to see you again.
No.
We don't have time. We have to go to a commercial.
Well, no, one more. Now for this last one. Usually, you don't want to find a bug in your food. Now, I still don't want to find bugs in my food. But we are.
Bugs. Will it hummus?
Yep, we've got crickets, scorpions, a tarantula, and an assortment of crushed bug bits. So we got our barf buckets ready.
Can you see that, Jimmy? Can you see him reaching
out to you? Oh, I can see it. You know, he's not reaching out to me. I can kind of smell it as well. I'm not a person that's not like a thing.
There's a lot of protein in insects. This is the future of dying.
Yeah, man. In 20 years, all hummus is going to be like this. Okay?
You think so?
Yeah.
Even if I was, like, competing for $1 million, I'm not sure if I would do this.
All right. We call this...
We got news for you.
You're not.
I thought you were going to maybe surprise me. Well, we'll give you $1 million. Yeah, all right. Holy moly.
We call this one Bah Hummus Bug. Okay, but here's the thing. You got to get a bug on your pita.
Yeah. It's one of those yellow, crunchy things. I think that's like a larva.
Oh, gross.
Yeah, that's good.
Oh, gosh. Ew. Oh. This is about to be out.
You're digging for it. There we go.
There you go.
Now, look. Hold on.
You can't vomit first.
I know. I can't yet.
What if I feed it through the slot here?
Wait, my dude rolled off.
I got one for you.
Yeah, I appreciate it. That's what friends are for, buddy.
Now look, since you're willing to go this far, I'm just gonna use the scorpion as my chip. Hey, man.
All right. Hurry up, dink it. You didn't dink it. Don't dink it, oh no!
You can do it, I believe in you.
My hummus came up.
Oh, gross.
And sink it.
So you liked it.
Oh my gosh, that was the most disgusting, weird feeling ever. It was so gross. Kind of weirdly, kind of salty, maybe even.
Crunchy.
Well, you ate a scorpion. I had on pita. But I didn't spit it out.
You didn't?
No.
Which means it might hummus, but will it hummus?
No!
Yeah, I thought maybe it hummus. That did not hummus. That was too much business. And I couldn't even look at it. That did not hummus at all. So, yeah. Will it? What? That was a great addition of Will it.